My name is Kavya and Abhi are going to present about the practical aspects of prominent. Here you can able to see we have arranged leaves, flowers, fruits of the pomegranate fruit. Coming to pomegranate, as we all know, pomegranate is a very important table fruit crop. It is grown as evergreen. It is evergreen in tropical condition and it is deciduous in subtropical condition. The scientific name of pomegranate is Punica granata. This chromosome number is 12 is equal to 16 and 18. It belongs to family Liliaceae. The origin of pomegranate is from Iran. That is why it is known as national fruit of Iran. It is also known as fruit of love. The seeds of pomegranate are known as, the dried seeds of pomegranate are known as anardana. They are used as condiment. The rind of the pomegranate are used in the treatment of diarrhea and the flowers are used in the preparation of dyes. Then we start with the leaves.
Leaves are oppositely arranged and it is almost sessile with a small pedicle. And it is very crowded, leaves are very crowded on the twig and the twig, the pomegranate plant varies from tropical to subtropical. Like if it is a tropical, it is evergreen, and subtropical, it is deciduous plant. And its branching starts from the downside. It is bears some current season growth. And coming to the, there will be 1 to 2 flower per axil.
Then coming to flowers, there will be 3 types of flowers, mainly hermaphrodite flowers, intermediate flowers and male flowers. Coming to flower parts, there are mainly stamen, pistil, corolla, calyx and pistil. Stamens are consist of anther and filaments. The anthers are of several hundred, approximately of 300 anthers will be present. And pistil is solitary, that means only single style is present, which is of yellow color in the base and it is of pink color stigma at the top. And corolla have 5 to 8 stamens. The sepals are fused and is known as gamosepals and petals are free. Then coming to types of flowers, hermaphrodite flower, here you can able to see both male and female part. The male part is anther and the female part is style and stigma. The length of the anther is shorter than that of the style, that means the style is longer than that of the anther. The only hermaphrodite flowers will contribute to the fruit set. And coming to intermediate flowers, even intermediate flower contains both male and female reproductive parts, but the length of the style is less than that of the anther, that means it exhibits heterostyly, that is why it is cross-pollinated flower. Then coming to size, shape of the flower, both hermaphrodite and intermediate flowers are a base shape, that means here you can able to see the bulge at the base. And coming to male flowers, it has both style and stamen, but the style is degenerated and rudimentary, hence it is known as male flower. This will not contribute to the fruit sets. These flowers will fall off after pollination, that means these flowers will not contribute to any fruit set. And these are of bell shaped. Here you can able to see the bell shape at the base of the flower. And this is the unopened flower bud, which is yet to be opened. And this is unpollinated flowers. See, here you can able to see the no anthers were found. Then one more important thing which is to be observed here is that the corolla will fall off after pollination. That means the indication of pollinated flower is falling down of corolla.
Coming to the fruits. Fruits is a large glabrous berry known as balusta, and the fruit is 10 to 12 centimeter diameter. And inside the fruits we have so much of segments, and the fruits have persistent calyx. And it is covered by a rind. It is very coriaceous, and the rind can be used for the dyes, as she said earlier. And inside the fruit, we can see seeds. Seeds are irregular shape, and it is covered with a testa. Testa is a juicy, which is known as arils, and it is almost red color. It's edible. Both seeds and testa, arils are edible.
Coming to anthers in pollination, anthers is time it varies from variety to variety. For example, in some variety it takes place in 7 a.m. and for some cultivars it is but well known. And anther dehiscence is 3 to 3.5 hours after anthesis. The optimum temperature for anthesis and anther dehiscence is 37 to 38 degrees Celsius. Mostly pomegranate is both self-pollinated, cross-pollinated and often cross-pollinated. Coming to hermaphrodite flowers is both self-pollinated and cross-pollinated. The cross-pollination is due to heterostyly and also because of insects. The major pollinators in case of pomegranate are honeybees. Thank you.